Hi friends, I have a new book to share with you today. The name of this book is called I'd Choose You, and the author of this book, the author writes the words, his name is John Trent, and I wrote him a letter and asked if I could use this book, and he said that I could. And the illustrator, that's the person who makes the picture, is Judy Love. And there's a picture of an elephant on the front. How do you think the elephant is feeling? I wonder what will happen in this story to the elephant. Let's check it out. Norbert, the little elephant, had a very sad look on his face as he slowly walked up the steps to his house. This had been the worst day of his whole life. Oh, look at Norbert. He looks like he's had a really tough day. Mom, said Norbert, it's been an awful day. Nothing's gone right since I left for school this morning. Look, I see Norbert has a tear on his face. What is his mommy doing to make him feel better? What does your mommy do to make you feel better? Maybe she gives you a tissue or a hug. Let's find out what was so bad about Norbert's day. You didn't miss the roller coaster again, did you? His mother asked. Because where they lived, all the kids took roller coasters to school instead of buses. No, I got to the roller coaster stop just in time, but everyone else had someone to sit with, and I had to sit all by myself in the very last row. And then at lunch, all the fifth graders decided they wanted to sit at the table by the window. And that meant the only place that was left was with Heidi the hippo. But Heidi's a nice girl, Norbert's mother said. Mom, she thinks she's my girlfriend. She even tried to put her head on my shoulder. Oh, it was so awful. She lost her balance and she fell in my mashed potatoes right in front of all the fifth graders. Oh dear, Norbert is feeling very embarrassed. Then, after school, I went out to play ball. And when they picked teams, there was one kid too many. You, said his mother quietly. Yes, me. Nobody likes me. Nobody wants to pick me. And as Norbert spoke, a big tear rolled down his trunk. He's feeling very lonely. All his friends left him over on the side. Norbert, his mother said in her soft, warm voice, if I could use my arms to hug only one child, guess which one I'd choose? Well, that's easy, said the little elephant. You choose Puffy Panda because he's so soft. Everyone likes to hug Puffy. And since Puffy is so big, everybody can hug him all at the same time. Puffy looks a little bit like my teddy bear from when I was a little girl. No, mother smiled. Guess again. If I could give a You're Somebody Special medal to only one child, guess who I would choose? Oh, Mom, you choose Florence the Flamingo. She deserves a medal because she's the only one who can do a triple loop when we all go ice skating. No, said Norbert's mom. Guess again. If I could use my voice to cheer for only one child, guess which one I'd choose? Well, that's easy too, said Norbert. You'd choose Ralph the Rhino. Everyone cheers for him because he's so brave. He even jumps off the high diving board. No, said Mother. Guess again. If I could help just one child realize what an exciting and wonderful future God has for him, a future where he can become anything he wants to be, guess which one I'd choose? Mom, that's a no-brainer. You'd choose Cassie the Caterpillar because she'll be a beautiful butterfly someday. No, not Cassie the Caterpillar, Mother chuckled. If I could use my arms each day to hug and my voice to cheer, if I could honor one child who has an exciting and wonderful future, if I could teach him every day that he's God's special gift, especially on those days when he doesn't get picked, guess which one I'd choose every time? I'd choose you.
And I'd choose you too, said Father Elephant, who had just come in the door.
Daddy! Norbert the Elephant yelled as he ran to hug his dad. And we're not the only ones who would choose you, said his father with a smile.
Really?
Said Norbert. Heidi the Hippo is outside with ice cream, and she's waiting for you, said Father.
Oh no, Norbert gasped.
The end. So let's talk about this story using our five-finger rule. Who was in this story? Can you think of some of the characters that were in this story? There was the mommy elephant, and the daddy elephant, and Norbert the elephant. Who was so fun to hug, do you remember? Puffy the panda, yes. Who was gonna turn into a butterfly? Cassie the caterpillar, and there was a flamingo, and some hippos and a rhino. Can you think of some other characters in this story? Where did this story take place? Was it out in the forest? No, it was in Norbert's neighborhood and at Norbert's school. What happened at the beginning of the story? How did Norbert feel in the very beginning? I remember he had tears down his face and he was telling his mom it had been a very bad day. In the middle of this story, Norbert told his mom all of the bad things that happened to him. He didn't get picked at school. He didn't have anybody special to sit with at lunch. He had had a really bad day. At the end of the story, his mom and dad told him that they would choose him every time because God loved him and he was special. And who else chose Norbert? Do you remember who was at the end of our story? Who was waiting with ice cream to make Norbert feel better? Heidi the Hippo. Beginning, middle, and end. Thanks for joining me for this story. See you soon.